the feast beside the sea and what followed it. When the 12 disciples came back to Yahushua after preaching in his name among the villages of Galilee, they told him of all that they had done and of what they had said to the people. The multitude seeking after Yahushua were now greater than ever before, for it was again near the time of the Passover, and very many on their way to Jerusalem turned aside to see and to hear the great teacher. So many people were coming and going that they could scarcely find time even to eat. Yahushua said to the 12, "Come with me apart into a quiet place, away from the crowds, and let us rest for a while." They went into the boat and rowed across the lake to an open place where no one lived, to a place not far from the city of Bethsaida. But they could not be alone, for the people saw them coming and watched them from the shore, and went on foot around the northern end of the lake and found them. When Yahushua saw how eager the crowds were to hear him, he took pity on them and taught them and healed such among them as were sick. As it began to grow toward evening, the disciples said to Yahushua, "This is a lonely place, and there is nothing here for such a crowd of people to eat. Send them away before it is too late, and tell them to go to the towns and get food." But Yahushua said to them, "They need not go away. You can give them food to eat." They said to him, "Shall we go into the town and buy $30 worth of bread so that each one of them may have a little?" Yahushua turned to Philip, one of his disciples, and said to him, "Philip, where shall we find bread that all these may eat?" Yahushua said this to try Philip's faith, for he himself knew what he would do. Philip looked at the great crowd, full 5,000 men, besides women and children, and he said, $30 worth of bread would not be enough to give to everyone even a little piece." Just then another of the disciples, Andrew, the brother of Peter, said to Yahushua, "There is a boy here who has 5 loaves of barley bread and 2 little fishes. But what use would they be among so many people?" Yahushua said to the disciples, "Go out among the people and divide them into companies of 50 and 100 and tell them to sit down in order." So the people all sat down and upon the green grass arranged in rows and squares in their garments of different colors. They looked like beds of flowers. Then Yahushua took into his hands the 5 loaves and the 2 fishes which the boy had brought. He looked up to heaven and blessed the food, and broke the loaves and the dried fishes and gave the pieces to the disciples. They went among the companies of people and gave to everyone bread and fish as much as each needed. So they all ate and had enough. Then Yahushua said, "Gather up the pieces of food that are left, so that nothing may be wasted." Each of the disciples carried a basket among the people. And when they came to Yahushua, all the 12 baskets were filled with the pieces that were left over of the 5 loaves and the 2 fishes. When the people saw that here was one who could give them food, they were ready at once to make Yahushua their king and to break away from the rule of the Romans. Yahushua was a king, but he would not be such a king as they wished. His kingdom was to be in the hearts of men who loved him, not a kingdom set up by the swords of soldiers. He found that his disciples were ready to help the people to make him a king, even against his own will. So Yahushua first compelled his disciples to go on board the boat, though they were not willing to do so, and to row across the lake to Capernaum. Then he sent away the great crowd of people who were still eager that he should be their king. And when all had gone away and he was left alone, he went up into the mountain to pray. While he was praying in the night, a great storm arose upon the lake, and from the mountain, Yahushua could see his disciples working hard with their oars against the waves, although they could not see him. A little after midnight, when the storm was the highest, Yahushua went to his disciples walking up on the water just as though the sea was dry land. The men in the boat saw a strange figure coming near them up on the sea and cried out with fear, for they thought it must be a spirit. But Yahushua called out to them, "Be of good cheer, it is I. Be not afraid." And then they knew that it was their master, Messiah. Peter spoke to Yahushua and said, "Master, if it be thou, let me come to thee walking up on the water." And Yahushua said to Peter, "Come." Then Simon Peter leaped overboard from the ship, and he too walked on the water to go to Yahushua. But when he saw how great was the storm on the sea, he began to be afraid, and forgetting to trust in the word of Yahushua, he began to sink. He cried out, "Lord, save me!" And Yahushua reached out his hand and caught hold of him and lifted him up, saying, "Oh, man of little faith, why did you doubt my word?" When Yahushua came on board the boat with Peter, at once the wind ceased and the sea was calm. The disciples wondered greatly as they saw the power of Yahushua. They fell down before him and said, in truth, thou art the Son of Yahuwah. When they came to the shore and the daylight arose, they saw that they were at the land of Gennesaret, a plain, a little to the south of Capernaum. They went ashore, and as soon as the people saw Yahushua and knew who he was, they brought their sick to him and begged that they might only touch the border of his garment. And as many as touched him were made well. Soon after this, Yahushua came again to Capernaum and went into the synagogue, which was full of people, some of whom had eaten of the 5 loaves a few days before. These people wished Yahushua to feed them in the same way again. But Yahushua said to them, "Seek not for food that passes away, but for the food that gives everlasting life, such as the Son of Man can give you." They said to him, "What sign can you show that Yahuwah has sent you?" "Moses gave our fathers bread from heaven, the manna in the desert. What can you do? You have read of the manna which fed the Israelites in the wilderness." Then Yahushua said to them, "It was not Moses, but Yahuwah who gave your fathers bread. And Yahuwah gives you now the true bread from heaven in his Son who came down from heaven to give life to the world." As soon as the people found that Yahushua would not work wonders to please them, they turned away from him and left him, although only a few days before they would have made him a king. When Yahushua saw that the great crowds of people were with him no longer, Yahushua said to his 12 disciples, "Will you also go away and leave me?" Then Simon Peter answered him, "Lord, to whom else can we go? For thou only hast the words that will give us everlasting life." The scriptures are found in Matthew 14, verse 13 to 36, Mark 6, verses 30 to 56, Luke 9, 10 to 17, John 6, 1 to 71. May Yahuwah continue to bless all his children with great knowledge. Shalom.